Hi everyone, today we'll dive into Kubernetes Horizontal Pod Autoscaler with two hands-on demos. First demo, we'll use command line to create a horizontal pod autoscaler and run load testing in nginx service to check the horizontal pod autoscaler behavior. In second demo, we'll create another horizontal pod autoscaler with behavior speck and run the same load testing again to check horizontal pod autoscaler status. We'll see the HPA status are different between two demos. The Minikube is used in my hands-on demos, so the demo has zero cost. If you are interested in seeing the horizontal pod autoscaler demo in AWS EKS, please leave your comments below. We'll do it together. Hello everyone. Welcome back to my channel. My name is Lian Duan, and I have developed for over 20 years, specializing in DevOps and cloud security. You can find all the video related content and the demo code in my GitLab repository. The links are below. If you watched my video, Kubernetes Autoscalers, feel free to go to hands-on demos. The timeline is in the comment. Now, let's start by overview Kubernetes Autoscalers. What is a Kubernetes Autoscaler? In simple word, Kubernetes Autoscaler helps your pods work effectively by adjusting the number of pods. Kubernetes Autoscaling are two levels, pod and node. At the pod level, we have two autoscalers, horizontal pod autoscaler and vertical pod autoscaler. Horizontal pod autoscaler can add, remove pod in a Kubernetes node. Vertical pod autoscaler is able to change the pod CPU and memory size in the same pod. It's called in-place pod resource resizing. Before Kubernetes version 1.27, the resize process will restart the pod. It causes downtime. In Kubernetes 1.27, the resize process is able to without restart a pod. I'm not suggesting use vertical pod autoscaler in production environment. The Kubernetes 1.27 is released on the last year, 2023. Need time to watch it. Other reason, the vertical pod autoscaler is for stateful size pod. If we have to use the stateful size pod, why do not use cloud provider service? Then, at the node level, we have the cluster autoscaler and the carpenter. They are working on high level, managing the node themselves, ensuring your cluster has the right number of workers to handle the workload. Cluster autoscaler is traditional autoscaler. Carpenter is a new generation autoscaler. It's more faster and effectively, also will save your cost because it's able to calculate and select right size node for your cluster. Today, we'll focus on the horizontal pod autoscaler. Horizontal pod autoscaler, or HPA, is like your personal pod manager. HPA automatically adjusts the number of pods based on how busy they are. If your pods getting too much traffic, HPA step in to balance things out. There is an example, metric service or permissions collect the pod CPU and the memory usage information. HPA checks metrics on each 30 seconds by default. When the metrics reach to threshold, HPA will create new pod. When the traffic gets lower, HPA will remove the pod. Let's move to the hands-on demos. Before we start, make sure you have good things ready. Minikube and kubectl command. If you do not have this yet, check out the Minikube website to get the installation guideline. Also, I have videos for installing Minikube on Windows, Mac OS, and Linux. We're also going to need Apache Bench, a tool we're using for load testing. If you're on Mac like me, it's already pre-installed. Otherwise, in Linux, you can run command apt-get install apache-2-utils. In Windows, use chocolate install apache-httpd. If you face any questions, leave them below. I'll try to help you out. Now let's dive into setting up Minikube and some key configurations. Make the world bigger. So start Minikube. Command is Minikube space start. The command kick off a local Kubernetes cluster using Minikube. Next, we enable matrix server addon to help us keep eye on our cluster. Command is Minikube addons enable matrix -server. Enter. The addon is enabled. Clean up the screen. To double check everything is running smoothly, to run kubectl API resource command. The command gave us the list of all different parts of Kubernetes we can use. Move a little bit up. We want to find the Horizontal Pod Autoscaler API version. We got it. Horizontal Pod Autoscalers API version is V2. Clean up. Latest. Open the Minikube dashboard so we have some GUI to check all the resources in the Kubernetes. That will make our life easier. So there you have it. With just a few simple commands, we set up a Minikube. Go the monitoring tool is running and open the dashboard to keep eye on for the old Kubernetes resources. Switch back to the terminal. Open new tab. Let's move to the deploying nginx web server and test it out. Go to my code folder. You'll see there are two YAML files. First thing first, we'll deploy the nginx server and setting things up for testing. Our demo HPA will watch the nginx server performance and making sure things are running smoothly. Quick go through hpa-demo-nginx YAML file. The deployment says we want to one nginx pod running, labeled with hap-hpa-demo. The service named hpa-demo-service. It will forward network traffic to nginx pod. The port is 80. To get things rolling out, run command kubectl apply space -f plus the YAML file name. Two resources are created. Clear up the screen. Next up, we need to make sure we can access our nginx server from our local machine. We have to run command sudo -e kubectl port forward. The password is your Mac login password. Duplicate type to make sure we're in the same folder. Next, let's check all things are working. Use command curl plus local IP address 127.0.0.1. It sent request to nginx server. If all things going right, we'll see the default nginx welcome page. We got it. There is a default nginx welcome page. So far, we deployed nginx. Make sure we can access it locally. Everything is ready. It's time to create HPA. We are creating, managing, and load testing a horizontal pod autoscaler in Minikube. Let's go through setting up HPA in Minikube step by step. First hands-on demo, we'll create a simple HPA. We use a command line to do it. Clean up the screen. The command is set up the HPA for deployment, HPA demo deployment, setting the target CPU usage 5%. That means when pod CPU usage over 5%, HPA will create a new pod and making sure we always have at least one pod, but not more than 5 pods. Enter. HPA created. If you need help, use command kubectl autoscaler space --hap. You will see all the parameters. This gives you all the info you need to use autoscaler in Kubernetes. Clean up the screen. To check out how HPA is doing, you can use kubectl get hpa space w command. The command will update HPA status in time. Duplicate type. Let's see how set up some heavy traffic. We'll run a load testing. It will send 100 concurrent requests and the total will send 100,000 requests to local endpoint 1.27.0.0.1. The load testing help assimilate how the HPA responds to the increased traffic by scaling the number of pods based on the CPU utilization. Back to the HPA status tab. Open other window. We check the pod status. The CPU usage is 14 right now. The pod number increased from 1 to 3. All the 3 pods are running. Open new tab, start another load testing. It helps us quickly see the pods number increase to the 5. More pods are coming in the pending stage. The pod number is reached to maximum is 5. There is no any workload, so the CPU use percentage is 0 right now. We should see the pod number decrease in 5 minutes. When we open the dashboard, you will see the replica side is changed. Previous only 1, right now it's 5. HPA will reduce from 5 to 1. Also, there is a chart for CPU and memory usage status. Back to the command window. HPA reduced the pod number from 5 to 1. We see the pod number increase or decrease based on the traffic. Could we configure how quickly the pods adding or removing? Yes, we can do it. Just delete our current HPA. Command is a kubectl delete HPA plus HPA name. Check current path. Open a new tab. Close one of them. We'll create a second HPA with the behavior spec. Open hpa-behavior-demo.yaml file. We're setting up a horizontal pod autoscaler to manage our deployment. The HPA name is hpa-demo-cpu-autoscalers. It ensures that we always have between 1 and 5 pods running based on the CPU usage. Move a little bit down. If the CPU usage is scaled up by adding 1 pod every 30 seconds, if the usage lowers the 5% by removing 1 pod every 1 minute, stabilization time window is 10 seconds. The default value is 5 minutes. Use command kubectl apply -f plus the YAML file name to create a second HPA. Autoscaler is created. Let's run 2 same load testing again. The CPU usage is increased. 1 pod is created. The CPU usage is 14 right now. The pod number is reach the threshold is 5. Let me kill the workload to quickly see the pod number gets down. 2 load testing stopped. We should see the pod number gets down. To summarize our second demo, we apply the HPA behavior spec on our NGX pod on Minikube. Run load testing our app and see the pod number increase, decrease based on the workload. You see the pod reduced by each minute. It matches our behavior spec. Also in demo 1, HPA removed 4 pods in 1 time. Alright, this is all for today's video. Today we learned HPA concept. We are able to create HPA from command line or from YAML file with the behave spec. Thank you for watching and see you next time.